living, shall sing songs you've never heard, just like they're singing as you join in by my spirit. And he said that you'll be turned into another man. 1 Samuel 10, verses 6. 2 Kings 3:15. The prophet Elijah said, bring in minstrel. That's a King James term for a musician. Let him play a sound. And the hand of the Lord come upon me and I'll prophesy. And God will make this valley become a place of victory. All because of a sound. For the people of God, praise God. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20. As Jehoshaphat commanded them according to the word of the Lord. They began to sing, verse 21. They never finished their song. They just started singing. And the Lord joined in their to have you in the house tonight. Before we, amen, change the order of service, hold of the spirit that's flowing in here. Just reach over and touch somebody standing next to you. I just feel led of God to do it that way. Say in the name of Jesus, your need is being met right now. Come on, just pray for them just a few seconds right there. Because I believe somebody's getting a touch right now. A needed touch. Amen. Somebody's been, amen, somewhere that they thought they weren't going to make it out of. You've been alone. All this worship tonight has helped you. But God said, I want to make it personal. I want to let you know that I know you and where you're at. And I am literally, amen, personally touching you right where you are. By the hand of the one that's around you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I declare that that you have need of. Amen. Prophecy was spoke over you. Amen. Yes. All was slim is for you to live. Yes. Look at somebody and say, I don't care where I was at yesterday this time.
I don't care where I was at yesterday this time.
And I don't know where I'll be at tomorrow this time. But right now, I'm in the presence of God. And God's in my presence. And it sure feels good. That's 101 worship tonight. That's just how easy it is to get in the presence of God. And then to hear all the stuff that God spoke. I told Brother Marvin over and over and over, he needs to get somebody with a recorder and record all that stuff he says under the anointing to play and sing like that and write him a song. Amen. And all his words are going to be over. Because that's anointing. Amen. Brother Marvin sits at those drums tonight. He hadn't asked me to say this. And I'm not going to say too much, Brother Marvin, so don't be careful. Brother Marvin and myself are praying for answers from God. We need you to pray with us. He spoke something tonight and said that God said he was going to give us this city. I've shared with you briefly, and I've shared with the leaders, amen, in detail, what I see every time I close my eyes. Amen. I don't know, Brother Martin, but I just believe street meetings is about to come back alive with me and you. Amen. They won't come where we at. We're just going to go where they are. Amen. I believe God's going to start a revival out there on the street. It's going to come off the street and come in the house. And God's going to do great things. See, we've been trying to start a revival in the house and carry it to the streets, and it ain't working. I think God's saying we're doing it the wrong way. The only time is you can go out on the street and do it, and then they follow them back to church. Look at your neighbor and say, we're about to win this town for the Lord. But I'm going to tell you, when you make a drive through this town, whether you come to church or whether you live here, this is what I want to challenge you to do in closing tonight. I want you, every time you ride any, amen, inch, amen, or tenth or mile in this town, every time you're riding the streets of this town and you're riding by people's houses, say, God, in the name of Jesus, save this town. In the name of Jesus, God, release your blessing
which has been proclaimed over this town. Will you do that with me? Every time you come in, every time you leave, if you live here, amen, every day, wake up, amen, walk out in your yard, amen, if you live in this town, and declare, God save this town. Bless this town. I don't know what is so special about this town, but for 40 years, God has put, amen, two people's lives on hold and said, this is where I want you. Amen. My daddy, David Inman, Sr., amen, or David Inman, amen, and then Samuel David Inman. All my life has been nothing but an uproar, amen, for this town. I don't know what God wants to do in this town, but I go and dig. He hadn't done it just yet. Amen. When he does it, it's going to be something that everybody's going to know that he's done. Amen. Are you in the room with me? So, amen. Would you do that with me this week? Spend time. Did you pray with me today? And I don't mean for you to raise your hand, but I just want to ask you, amen. I can tell you at the end of the house, amen, we pray. Amen. We sought the Lord. We read the Word. Amen. And I can tell you God will make a difference in your life. Look at somebody and say, God's about to turn it around. Let's do something if you really believe that. If you really believe that, I want you to do it with me. You say, Pastor David, that's about crazy. But if you believe something, you'll live it. Shake somebody's hand, hug somebody's name, tell them it's been good to be in God's house. God bless you. Have an enjoyable holiday tomorrow and labor somewhere.